I recently did a piece on entry-level fountain pens, i.e. pens under £20 that you might have seen. Today though, if you are new to fountain pens or you're wanting to upgrade from a utility model, we need to ask ourselves one question. Why spend more? In this film, I'm looking at 8 different branded pens priced between £45 and £85 in the UK. And we'll look at some of the features that add the pounds to the price ticket. I hope you find it interesting. So this is the range we're going to be looking at today. I've got 8 different pens here. Some of them are more conventional in design, some of them a little bit more quirky. All mainstream brands, all under £100 UK RRP as well. So let's dive in and have a look. So let's look at some of the features of these pens to find out why they're priced between £45 and £85. Firstly, we've got the Parker IM. Now Parker, big brand, one of the best known brands in the world, and this IM comes in over 6 different finishes, priced between £45 and £70. The nib unit is better than the basic Vector, the utility model that they have, and it's a smart, stylish design with classic Parker looks, accentuated with the arrow clip here. So yeah, all over, very smart looking mid-range pen. The Lamy Studio is next. Now, Lamy have 10 different finishes in these, and they do a special edition every year as well. Solid and weighty, and they will describe it as is where art meets design. Certainly, although it's got the same Z50 nib as the Lamy Safari, it writes really nicely, it feels great in the hand, and it looks very smart and fashionable. More classic in design is this Art Deco-inspired Conklin Durograph, and this is Orange Knight. It's a resin pen, and the design sort of is a throwback to maybe some of the old Parker Durofolds and the old Delta pens as well. Beautiful big open nib, steel again, but quite flexible, nice ink flow, fills from a bottle or uses cartridge, and really is quite a stylish classical design. On the quirky side, we've got something like this. This is the Twisby Mini AL. It's a substantial plastic as opposed to some of the plastics you get on the utility models, which feels brittle. This actually feels pretty solid. The metal parts are good. The nib is exceptionally smooth. I've got a stub one in this. And quirkiness comes from its size and the fact that it is a piston fill only. These anodized aluminium parts, both in the filling mechanism and on the shell, make it look quite unusual as well. When the cap's on, it's quite short. Typically £60 to £70, depending on the nib that you choose. On the quirky line is my favourite little bulletproof Kaweco brass sport fountain pen. It's one of many metal finishes that Kaweco produce. I like this raw brass. It's heavy and it develops its own patina. I don't generally polish it. There's a good nib selection. It's just a good compact pocket pen. Seemingly never lets me down as well. Now, from quirky to a little bit more business-like, we've got the Schaefer Intensity here. It's very smart, it's quite weighty, and this engraved chrome finish on the barrel and the cap feels really nice, and it just looks quite a professional unit. Being Schaefer, you've got the little white dot in the clip, that's their little trademark, like Parker have their arrow, and it just is a very smart, very user-friendly pen. Again, steel nib, and it comes with a converter as well, which, unlike some of the other pens, if you wanted to fill it from a bottle, you'd have to buy the converter separately. So it irks me a little bit. I think I'm just a bit old-fashioned. Next, the Cross Wanderlust. Now, this is one of 4 finishes. This is the Borneo, and it's a sort of lacquer, a metallic finish, almost like the old-fashioned Cloisonne arts, sort of art and crafts finish from many, many years ago. The gold trim, the subtle lines of the Century 2 cross, etc., make this look really a very sort of stylish and bonny pen. Be a great gift for somebody. As I say, four different finishes. Cross's famous lifetime mechanical warranty. It's just a very elegant pen and writes very nicely too. Finally, we've got the Lamy Scala. There's a choice of finishes in this. This particular one is the Deep Violet. It's the 2019 special edition. Features on this, it's a heavy, some say quite clunky design, but it's a sprung clip. really rich enamel finish. Again, it's the Z50 nib, but it's got a bit of weight and substance about it as this, and it just feels good in the hand. So typical Lamy quality, really. But at £85, is it £65 worth more than, say, the Safari pen? Most of these have got matching ballpoint pens, rollerballs, and pencils as well, which is something you don't usually get with the less expensive utility fountain pens. So what have we learned? I hope by running through these 8 pens, I've managed to illustrate to you how some of the manufacturers add some of those pounds to the price tag. Certainly, with many of these pens, you get quality brand with the kudos that goes along with them. Many of them have got long history and reputations that are second to none. You get style and design, you get substance, you get choice in finishes and writing modes. Many of them have got matching ball pens, pencils or rollerballs too. Performance and durability is key as well. So much more robust than something that's under £20 perhaps. And overall, they give you pleasure. So I hope that really sets the scene as to what you might get if you push the budget a little bit more. The fountain pen world caters for all budgets, and I think next time I'll look at pens with gold nibs for you, just to try and illustrate what the gold nib experience brings to your inky fingers. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you to Jespers of Harrogate for lending me some of these pens so I could talk to you about them today. Which one do you fancy? Are you going to upgrade or are you going to stick? Keep well, everybody.